man come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
FA Cup, Sheffield Wednesday. Yeah, let's not talk about that one. 4-0 loss. But this is a game we have to get a result out of today. Leeds at home. Everyone knows the rivalry. And we've got to do something today. Obviously, a bit of not much transfer news coming out as of late. Loads of players we've been linked with as well, but we desperately need a striker 100%. Ike Ogbo has obviously gone back to Troyes and then signed for Sheffield Wednesday. To be honest, I do think that'll benefit us in the long run. He's not one of the worst strikers, obviously, we've had on loan, but at the same time, I do think it was for the best, unfortunately. So, yeah, some good moments there, but aside from that, it'll be interesting to see who we play up front today as well and what sort of system we go for. Aaron Ramsey's close to coming back soon, but obviously he's not going to be participating probably this month either. So it'll be interesting to see what Bullet does, to be honest. Aside from that, it's absolutely Baltic today. So let's do it.
I wouldn't say it's a must-win game or a must-draw game, Nathan. I'm more looking for a performance, really, because of... Okay, it was a good 3 points against QPR, wasn't it, a couple of weeks ago. But aside from that, we haven't been performing at all. Goals are really coming hard to come by, especially from our front line. I know Callum Grant scored, was it 2 or 3 goals in the last month or so? But no goals against Sheffield Wednesday, albeit it was a much changed side. But that result, QPR, you look there, both of the goals coming from defenders, both from set pieces. So we're finding it difficult to score from open play. So I'm looking more for a performance against a real tough Leeds side. Hopefully it's going to, well, from our point of view, it'll be a tight game. Hopefully we'll go at them a bit, but we've got to be really wary of their wide men in Somerville and, of course, Dan James. And talking about the Swansea contingent there, so I expect that here himself and Perrault and Rodon, they'll get a warm welcome. I'm sure, as we said on previous videos, the crowd hasn't really been loud and ferocious and intimidating or anything, but that kind of stems from the pitch as well. So hopefully we'll get some real good tackles in the first few minutes, and that'll get the crowd going, hopefully. And hopefully then we can take something from this game. We're more than capable. Just, you know, how we start and what the how we go about the tempo and everything. But intriguing game up against Leeds side, who have, was it, lost the last 3 league games away from home. But yeah, they had a real good win against, well, I think it was Peterborough away in the FA Cup. Okay, and a win against, I think it was Coventry as well, or Leicester, yep, recently. So, you know, we know they're dangerous, but hopefully you'll get something.
City loves you more than you are, though. Whoa, here's to you, Peter Whittingham. City loves you more than you all know. Whoa! City loves you more than you all know. Whoa! Peter Whittingham. City loves you more than you all know. Whoa! Here's to you, Peter Whittingham. City loves you more than you all know. Whoa!
Oh, we've been sliced open! You absolute donkeys! Some jokers!
Goalie Rowell with a goal for the visitors, scored by number 9, Patrick Bamford.
Oh, unlucky Rossi. Come on, push it forwards! Come on. Lucky, come on.
Sally!
Sally! Oh, we shot ourselves in the foot again. Well done. Wake up, breath. God, come on. Tessie should have had that. Come on. Sally! Sally! Come on, lads. Right, come on, top corner. Let's go. Save, well done. Well done. So lucky there again.
City!
Go. Oh, lucky. Come on, back in. Come on. There we go. Oh my God. Oh, lucky. We go, come on, forwards. Oh, come on. Offside! 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 Are you joking?
It's offside!
Goal in a well game for the visitors, scored by number 20, Dan James. Cardiff City 0, Leeds United 2.
Of all the players as well. Okay, so that's the end of the first half, and that was absolutely shocking. I mean, 2-0 down, two pathetic goals conceded as well, just complete defensive clangers again. One of them in particular, letting Dan James pass it in, would have been offside if McGuinness wasn't such a donkey. And aside from that, Kitete glued to the floor. Siopis has been absolutely shocking as well. And, well, until Ruben Cole came on, we started to look a little bit better, but I'm sorry, but that was woeful. These players have not turned up again today. And my God, do we need a striker, because we've got no depth up there. Absolutely terrible. What do you think?
Yeah, absolutely shocking defending for both goals. Also, Siopis in second, just giving the goal away. Reminds me a little bit of Rolls against Leicester. First goal, pathetic. I think the player, he rode about 4 or 5 challenges, but overall he's been shocking. I think the bowler and possibly Wintle have done okay, but the rest of the Tete's not even in the game. Might as well take him off now, half time, and bring on Matey. At least he's, you know, he'll barge people about and stuff. But Collins is having a nightmare. I don't think the guy can read the game. He was so promised last season, and he's just been shocking the last month or two. But crowd as well, terrible. I know you've got to. It's got to come from the pitch as well, but there's just no atmosphere in the camp, and absolutely terrible. But hopefully we can do something second half. Look, they're tiny little bit better when Cole will come on for those last couple of minutes, so we'll see what happens.
Oh, unlucky, come on. He's playing better than this, come on. Da, 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 da. State of that shot. Come on, Ruben, wake up. Come on, ref! Come on, whip her in. Come on, gone. There we are, yeah, yeah, you're lucky. We'll keep pressing, come on! Shoot!
Oh, what was that, Rhino? Oh, that was terrible.
Save. Should have been 3-0 then, my God, we were so lucky. He's given a pen for that. What is this ref on?
Come on! Bobby Ome! Bobby Ome!
Oh, unlucky!
Come on! City!
Look at the space. There you go. Absolute joke. Slaughter, absolutely shocking.
Leeds scored by number 24, Jorginho Rutter. Paris City nil, Leeds United.
Slaughter, absolute shocking. Well, that second half was a bit better, wasn't it? But judging it from a whole, absolutely terrible. Aside from the second half, which at times we improved a bit, I have absolutely nothing positive to say. We absolutely need signings before next Saturday against Plymouth, because aside from that, we just have no depth. Some of the players just clearly aren't good enough, and we just gave Leeds so much respect. This is meant to be treated like a rivalry, yet we go out there like it's a training game. Some of these players are honestly an absolute joke. It's unbelievable. What do you think?
You can see that Leeds are, you know, head and shoulders above Cardiff quality-wise, but that doesn't give the excuse of just not turning up and trying to fight for the ball at every opportunity you can. But, you can be bottom of the league or you can be in a division below, and you can raise your game against these teams higher up the table and everything, and we just... Until the second half, it was only a 5-minute spell where we had a few really good passages of play. One of them, Rinomota, I think he had his shot was terrible, wasn't it? But overall, as you say, given too much respect, a little bit like the Leicester game, wasn't it? And okay, Leeds, much better team overall and everything, and the quality of player and all that, but. The lack of effort was at times through that match was it was very concerning, and we need a striker in ASAP, probably another midfielder I'd say, and definitely a defender, probably a left back. But the shocking defending first half, second half, they were just like Leeds were just playing with us at times, weren't they?
Yeah, they were.
Just couldn't get near them. And next week, Plymouth Argyle, probably more of our level, so hopefully we can get something out of that game. But not looking good. I mean, Bullet needs to get them on the training ground and pull something out of the bag for next week. We're only 3 points off playoffs. It's bizarre how tight this division. We've been on a terrible run. Okay, I know last league game we won, but playing not great at all at the moment, and how we're only 3 points away from that playoff zone at the moment is unbelievable.
Yeah, it absolutely is. But I mean, at the end of the day, things have got to improve, and they've got to improve quickly. But Plymouth away next week, we're going to see if we can go to it. We haven't actually met the minimum requirements to go to it as well, which is just so annoying. So hopefully they can drop it a bit so we can get those tickets. So touch wood on that one. But yeah, I've enjoyed it. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. If you can support the channel, that'd be appreciated. Follow my social medias. Follow all the football podcasts on Spotify. And I'll see you all next time. Au revoir.